I decided to have an abortion because I thought that was the only way I could have options. But I had it ultimately because I thought that was my only choice to have the options that I wanted in order to further move on in my life. I felt pressure from every aspect, whether it was for those who didn't even know about it. I felt that if I didn't have an abortion that I would be judged. I felt pressure from a financial aspect. I felt pressure from those who told me that they weren't gonna, you know, tell me what to do, or they weren't, you know, but you still feel like they're pressuring you just because of how they're looking at you. And then no one wants to be the reason you made that decision. So no one wants to really back you up either way, whether you're having one or you're not. But mostly I just felt pressure by the stigma, by having children, one outside of my marriage. I also just felt pressure to do it overall because I didn't know what I would do otherwise. I felt pressure by time.
Well, we adopted a child because I couldn't have one at the time. And so we always felt like adoption was something that was good. And once I found out I couldn't have children, adoption just seemed logical.
We had tried for several years to have our own child and through traditional means, but like she said, we just couldn't. So adoption, for some reason, adoption had always been on my mind. It became a natural choice just to adopt.
Adoption was never brought up to me, not even at the abortion clinic. I wasn't given options other than that was my only option. I didn't know that there was other places other than an abortion clinic to go to when you were in a crisis pregnancy. As far as adoption directly goes, it wasn't something that I even thought of because it was either I raised my child or I have an abortion. And I think there's a stigma more with giving a child up for adoption than to just have an abortion and keep it quiet. The right thing would have been to give my baby up for adoption rather than living with living with my decision, which is ultimately ending the life of my baby.
We had talked to people that had gone through adoption, and it had gone years before even being considered for placement.
I think it was a full-on year process for us, which apparently is very quick.
Yeah. But it was fairly easy, actually.
When I shot the scene going into the clinic, I tapped into that time where I felt I was really alone. I actually went to the clinic by myself because no one wanted to be a part of it. It uprooted an emotion of isolation again, and just feeling completely alone in that walk.
For me, it doesn't really seem that, you know, I don't, every morning when I see her, I don't think, okay, I adopted her. For me, it's no difference than if she was my own child. So I treat it kind of that way, you know. I know some people look at it and say, well, could you really love an adopted child the same way? But for me, I don't even think about it like that. I think of it, she's mine. You know, she may not look like me, her eyes might be different color than mine, but she's mine, so it's pretty natural to me.
When I was playing the graduation scene and watching my son graduate, it did give me a moment of, you know, wow, this could have been me in the future. Especially since it was my new baby that played the initial role of the infant that I was giving up. And when you're able to fast forward into the future like that, it's one of those things where it's like, man, what did I do? Which is something I think about all the time regardless.
There seems to be kind of some negative connotation to adoption based off of older practices as far as closed adoptions and things like that. And for so long, it seemed that people were almost ashamed to admit that they were adopted or ashamed to tell their children they were adopted. But in my mind, it seems like, you know, so much has changed since then that there really is a lot of positives to adoption. And I think that it's a great thing.
What I've noticed is a lot of the questions I receive are, you know, the open adoption. Are you going to tell her that she's adopted? How does her birth mom fit into it? And for us, when we initially looked into it, we heard all the same ideas that open adoption meant the birth mother was involved 130% in your life and a child's life, or it was completely closed and you had no idea who she was. But for us, it's really opened up another family side for us. It's similar to as if we now have extra extended family that, you know, the girls get Christmas gifts from, and occasionally, you know, you're in town, you'll stop by and see them, but they're not running your lives. They're just a part of it, just like your family is.
I regret my abortion for many, many reasons. I regret it, one, because it was, while it was done out of fear, it was done out of selfishness, ultimately. It was done out of, it was done for a reason that, because I wanted more options in my life without taking into account what this child, this baby had to go through in order for me to have more options. I'm regretful because I made an impulsive decision that I can never take back again. That's the one thing. I made many mistakes in my life, and I can always make up for them, whether it's I said something that hurt someone. I can always say sorry and hope they can forgive me. I can, you know, take a wrong turn here and there and always make the U-turn. You can't change an abortion. That life is gone forever. And mostly I regret how I'm going to explain to my children that I took their sibling away from them. Because that was their brother, that was their sister. So that's the main reason that I'm regretful.
I'm not a fan of abortion, but I've never been. Just because I've always been aware of how many people there are that would like to have a child, and how many children there are already in the system that would like a home.
There's no such thing as an unwanted baby. There's always someone that will want to love that child. There's only such thing as an unplanned pregnancy, that's it. But never an unwanted baby.
I think a lot of people are uncertain and maybe a little standoffish towards adoption, but having gone through it, I really think it's a great thing to give that child a chance. I think it's awesome, really.
What the video did for me is it gave me a moment to think more clearly, especially playing a role of a woman that obviously took a different route than I did. And it, when you're in a crisis pregnancy, you can't think clearly. So hindsight is 20/20, and being put in a position to where I can hypothetically go back on my decision, it showed me that the pain I would still feel a sense of pain and grief for not raising my child, but a sense of pride in what the possibilities for that child would have been if I just allowed him or her to live. And when you're able to finally think that way, it of course saddens you because you didn't take that route, but it gives me hope that I can tell other people that is the better route, the better plan.